Hey man, Shane here. For the past 6 years, the default recommendation has been to eat at least 0.7 to 1 gram of protein per pound of body weight per day to fully maximize your rate of muscle growth. So, for example, if you weigh 150 pounds, then you would need to eat at least 100 to 150 grams of protein per day. That recommendation was based on a 2018 meta-analysis by Morton and colleagues, with some of those colleagues including famous names like Eric Helms and Menno Henselmans. That's what guys like Jeff Nipper, Jeremy Etienne, and Mike Israetel would reference. And rightly so. That was the best evidence we had at the time. A month ago, Milo Wolf posted a controversial video arguing that we need 1.3 grams of protein per pound per day to maximize muscle growth, citing a 2020 meta-analysis by Tagawa and colleagues.
There is not a single study that has found benefits of more than 1.6 gram per kilogram per day.
Nearly all data on naturals illustrates that a gram per pound of protein is usually overkill in almost every case.
Here, the best research recommends 1.6 to 2.2 grams per kilo or 0.7 to 1 gram per pound per day.
Across the board, today's fitness influencers advocate for a protein target that is probably reducing your muscle growth. And I have the research to back that up.
The paper I'm about to discuss might broadly overturn much of what I've said, you've said, Menno said.
This is getting real embarrassing. Can we just bury this paper?
Let's just stop the video here. Stop recording. So 40% more growth by going from the current recommendation to a much higher one is a substantial difference.
Huge.
And most people, even if you go from 1 gram per pound to 1.3, it's still an appreciable difference in growth.
While some bodybuilders and especially supplement companies will continue to tout benefits of protein intakes up to 1 gram per pound or even higher intakes, there has been a relative consensus in evidence-based fitness. And for many years, there was peace. But recently, the peace has been disturbed. A new meta-analysis is making the rounds showing that supposedly the benefits of protein go up to 3.1 gram per kilogram, almost twice as much as previously believed. So is it time for a paradigm shift or are people crying wolf? I think the reason this meta-analysis was not previously given much attention because it simply doesn't deserve much attention for multiple reasons.
About the Tagawa paper?
Yeah, like I think Wolf on his, his YouTube channel, can I give you my take on why we went back to it?
Sure.
Because of the clickbaitiness. Mm. If everyone is going, you know what, 1.6 to 2.2 established, and you can go, hold on, but 2 years later, this lost meta-regression suggests that actually you can go to almost twice that amount and get meaningful benefits. Yeah. It is a, you know, so.
Yeah.
But the entire video was about this one study, which goes against the grain of all the other reported research and is clearly just out for clicks and views. Both of you are burning your credibility to the ground, and my heartfelt advice to both Renaissance Periodization and Milo is that don't trade your credibility for clicks. It's not hard to get clicks. It's hard to get your credibility back.
I wasn't fully convinced by Milo's arguments, but I wasn't sure. So I checked with the person who I think is the best at analyzing this type of research, Greg Nuckols from Stronger by Science. He told me that he'd just finished going through all the research on protein and that he'd been working on an article about it. He shared the draft with me, and he's just now published the full article. Greg found that when guys were eating less than 1 gram of protein per pound per day, then adding more protein tended to cause more muscle growth. But if they were already eating a gram of protein, then eating even more didn't tend to give them any extra growth. For example, in this bulking study, the participants were put in an estimated surplus of 400 calories per day, which is pretty typical while bulking. The participants that ate 0.7 grams of protein per pound gained less muscle than the group that ate 1.5 grams, but the differences didn't reach statistical significance, and even if they had, all it would tell us is that 0.7 grams isn't enough to maximize muscle growth. But maybe 0.8 grams would have been enough, and maybe that would have explained the difference. Or maybe if the participants had eaten 2 grams, they would have gained even more muscle than the group that ate 1.5 grams. We don't know where the breakpoint is. That's why Greg's analysis is so useful. He looked at all the relevant research, which gives him more statistical power, and he tried to find that specific breakpoint where eating more protein stopped causing extra muscle growth. You can see here in this chart that Greg Nuckols suspects the magic number is 0.9 grams per pound, but that it could go as high as 1.07 grams, giving us a rough rule of thumb of 1 gram of protein per pound per day. it's still fine to eat less. We know from the past 6 years that 0.7 grams is enough to build plenty of muscle, but you should be able to build even more muscle if you bump that up to a full gram. It's also fine to eat even more protein than that. It's just unlikely that the extra protein would yield any extra muscle growth. If I was a gambling man, I would probably be homeless and alone. But I think Greg is probably right on this. It's possible that somebody finds a hole in his analysis, but he's the most respected research reviewer in this muscle building niche we're in, and his article was quite thorough. With the evidence we have right now, this is the best guess we can make. And I think it will become the new default evidence-based recommendation that you get from guys like Jeff Nippert and Jeremy Etier. The other advantage to this recommendation is that it's a pretty old rule of thumb. When I first started bulking up over a decade ago, I was eating a gram per pound, and that's how I gained almost all of my muscle. I switched the lower end of that recommendation down to 0.7 grams when the evidence started pointing that way, but I'm happy to bump it back up to a full gram now that the evidence is pointing back this way. Finally, I asked Greg if this recommendation would change for skinny people. We can gain muscle unusually fast when we first start bulking up, more on that in this video, so I had this fear that maybe we could benefit from eating extra protein, but he says that's unlikely to be the case. All right, that's it for now. If you liked the video, thank you. I hope you decide to subscribe, and I hope to see you in the next one.